Today's video was requested by Marvin. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 8. The Japanese Spider Crab. This massive crab has the largest leg span of any arthropod, which can reach the impressive and scary length of 18 feet from claw to claw. This is particularly peculiar as its carapace grows only to be around 16 inches wide. Its weight is massive as well compared to other underwater arthropods, with some adults reaching an impressive size of 42 pounds. Their imposing exoskeleton is not only used to protect themselves from their natural predators, which include octopus and certain types of sharks, but also to effectively camouflage itself within its surroundings. Having a bumpy shell allows it to blend perfectly with the ocean floor, making it appear as just another rock laying around. To make the illusion even more uncanny, the crab adorns itself with sponges and marine flowers, which means if you ever bump into it, you'll never see it or its freakishly long legs coming. Number 7. The Giant Isopod. The Bathynomus giganteus, more commonly known as giant isopod, is basically the equivalent of the earthbound woodlouse, just a lot more disgusting and massively larger. Luckily for us, they mainly call the sea surrounding the Yucatan Peninsula home, near the coast of Mexico, and only at depths of 1,177 feet or deeper. We truly hope we never find them anywhere else, because these creatures are truly freaky. The giant isopod look like creepy little monsters, measuring up to 14 inches. They tend to feed on fish remains they find floating around the ocean floor. Interestingly enough, they can't even be starved to death, as they've been known to fast for a period as long as 5 years at a time. While they're waiting to scavenge for their next meal, they'll hide in the mud and wait patiently for a larger predator to leave part of their victim behind, like the little vultures they are. Luckily, they're hiding deep enough that you'll never unwittingly run into them during your next diving adventure. Before we move on, answer this quiz question. As the first land animals on Earth, how long ago were arthropods believed to have evolved? Was it A. 5,000 years ago, B. 500 million years ago, C. 50 billion years ago, D. None of the above. They're not the first land animals on Earth. Let us know what you think in the comments section below and stay tuned to find out the right answer. Number 6. The Antelope Crab. What sets this arthropoda apart from any other crab you might encounter? To start with, they've massive antler-like horns that stick out from either side of their heads, as well as incredibly long, thin legs. They're also known as carrier crabs, as they have the ability to keep a pair of walking legs over their shells and utilize them as hands to move around objects and even other invertebrates like sea urchins or corals. They can be more commonly found in Australia, where most monstrous animals dwell apparently, as well as in New Zealand and New Caledonia, but tend to remain in oceanic depths of 590 feet. This is one of the blessings we can count on, considering most of these shocking underwater arthropods tend to require high hydrostatic pressure to survive on. On second thought, this might be exactly what made them evolve to be this scary. Number 5. The Giant Waterbug. This monstrosity looks very much like a normal land cockroach, but calls lakes and rivers its home. To make them even more creepy and nausea-inducing, they also sport a pair of claws they can pinch their victims with, as well as longer antennae than the regular cockroach. As they can breathe underwater once they reach adulthood, these arthropods feature breathing tubes that easily retract into its abdomen in order to be able to remain underwater for long periods of time. They're also known as toe biters, and over 170 different types of giant water bugs have been found in freshwater habitats around the world, most commonly in Africa. They tend to prefer ponds and streams, and regretfully can be found outside the limits of the African territory, with some being discovered in America and Europe to a lesser extent. Most species are small, around 0.35 inches long, though some have been known to grow as large as 0.8 inches. The largest known kind, much to our horror, can reach the shocking size of 4.5 inches, right up there with the largest earthbound beetles ever discovered. Number 4. The water scorpion. Much like our previous entry, this arthropod closely resembles its land relative in most ways, but manages to be an even scarier version somehow. Its tail, along with the characteristic sting, features respiratory tubes, which, when extended above the surface of the water, allows the critter to breathe normally. The only relief we might experience is that though their bite is incredibly painful, it's far less harmful than the sting its land relative can produce in humans. The water scorpion can usually be found in ponds and streams, most predominantly around Asia, where locals enjoy meals featuring it as its main ingredient. But many species have also been discovered in America and around the globe. They typically grow up to 0.8 inches long, though it has been known to reach the 4.5 inches mark. Deadly or not, we certainly wouldn't enjoy being on the receiving end of their vicious attacks. Official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. Some of it is to die for. Number 3. Horseshoe Crabs. Though commonly referred to as crabs, they're nothing of the sort. They belong instead to the family of the Limulidae and can be found both in rivers and oceans, so you regretfully have more chances of running into them than you do with most of the other critters from this list. The horseshoe crab's habitat is shallow coastal waters with muddy floors, as they tend to be quite happy hiding just beneath the surface. They're commonly found in Asia, where they've become a thankfully not so popular dish over the centuries. Their entire body is protected by a hard, dark carapace, and they've two main lateral eyes along with several extra on the front and top of their heads, as well as one directly above its mouth. They have a massive amount of legs, some of which they use to help pin the female down during mating season, others for collecting their food or moving around on the ocean and river floor. To make this critter even more monstrous, its mouth is located in the center of its many, many limbs. The horseshoe crab is such an ancient species, dating back its origins to over 450 million years ago, that they're effectively considered living fossils. Basically, this means we'll most likely never get rid of them. So, how long ago were arthropods believed to have evolved? If you guessed B, you're right. Fossils and terrestrial tracks dating from 550 to 450 million years ago show that arthropods were pre-adapted to establish themselves on land, with their exoskeletons providing support against gravity and as a means of moving around without being dependent on water. Number 2. Sacculina carcini. This little critter is effectively a parasite that attaches itself to a very much unwilling host. In the case of the Sacculina, its preferred victim is usually the green crab resident of different regions in North Africa and Europe. Though they're the most common species to fall prey to this barnacle, other crabs are not safe from its stealthy attack. Not only is this arthropod utterly disgusting to stare at, but the way in which they survive is truly disturbing as well. Their calling life is to feed on and destroy its host bit by bit until they die of starvation. When first attaching themselves to the host they've selected, the Sacculina carcini inserts its stylet into the crab's fleshy areas and begins to crawl inside its body. Eventually, they force a sac to pop from the crab's side, creating tendrils that spread all through its body. These tendrils will begin to absorb all nourishment the host would otherwise retain, rendering them confused and weak. This way, the parasite effectively controls the victim's behavior, like the creepy little puppeteers that they are. In the end, the parasites will bring upon their own demise, as the crab will inevitably die from atrophy. Worst part yet, if the host is female, it will be forced to carry its parasite's eggs in their womb until it eventually perishes. Unable to regenerate their own limbs as they would under normal circumstances, or gain any nourishment from the meals they procure for themselves. Number 1. Cymathoa exigua. All you need to know about the Cymathoa exigua is its most popular moniker, the tongue-eating louse. If this isn't enough to make the hair stand up on the back of your neck, just hang on to your seat, because it's about to get a lot worse. The female Cymathoa will attach itself to the tongue of an unwilling victim, while her male counterpart will instead call the fish's gills home, just behind where his mate would first position itself. These parasites are small around 0.3 to 1.1 inches long, with the male always being slightly smaller than the females of the species. The truly nasty process in which they invade their host body begins when the parasite cuts into its host's blood vessels, focusing on the tongue until they eventually cause it to fall off altogether. Add an insult to injury, they'll then attach themselves to the stub left behind and effectively become the fish's new tongue, gaining nourishment from everything it eats. Several fishermen were incredibly shocked and disgusted to find fishes carrying around these disgusting little critters inside their mouths where their tongues should have been. Not a pretty sight to endure, especially without proper warning. We don't know about you, but we certainly wouldn't be calling that catch our next lunch. Thanks for watching. Would you rather wake up with a giant arthropod crawling in your bed, or be a triggered liberal? Let us know in the comments section below.